This video is about the announcement that Canada has made yesterday. It is a breathtaking, record-making, groundbreaking announcement. This news is even bigger than the big draw that was conducted on February 13th, where more than 27,000 CEC applicants were invited. Why? Let's discuss it in detail. The news is so big because Canada has announced a new pathway to permanent residency for over 90,000 essential temporary workers and international graduates. Do you hear that number? 90,000. Let's see what is the breakup of this 90,000. 20,000 applications for temporary workers in healthcare, 30,000 applications for temporary workers in other selected essential occupations, and 40,000 applications for international students who graduated from a Canadian institution. The numbers are astonishingly big, and yes, from that you would have guessed it right, that this is for all those people who are in Canada. So all those international students who recently graduated, all the essential healthcare workers, all those essential workers who have been working tirelessly since the last 1 year, since the pandemic has started. Many people have been working from home, but many essential workers have been going out, risking out their lives, and this is the reward that Canada is giving to them. They would have never thought that they would be able to get the permanent residency, but this is going to get possible. That's why I'm really happy for these people, because it was very difficult for them to get the PR, but now it would be possible. Okay, what are the timelines? Timelines are only for 6 months. Starting May 6th, 2021, less than a month from now, only 3 weeks, and would continue until November 5th, 2021, 6 months time for 90,000 applications. Isn't that a big news, guys? Now, all of those people who might be eligible who are in Canada and watching this video, guys, please note that this is a temporary public policy. This is not a pilot program, so don't think that okay, after 6 months, they would renew it again and we might be able to apply for it next year. No, this is a temporary public policy because of the pandemic. So this is a lifetime opportunity to get the Canadian PR. I would suggest that don't wait for the months of October, November. There's a certain quota that I told you earlier, and I won't be surprised if it gets filled in just couple of months time, in 3 or 4 months maybe. So don't wait for September, October or November. They've mentioned specifically there that any applications received after the intake cap for the respective stream has been reached will not be processed. So don't waste your time. Try to utilize this opportunity as early as possible. Okay, now I know there are two kinds of people: all those who are already there in Canada and those who are there in the rest of the world who are waiting that when the FSW draws will be conducted and when they will be able to get the ITAs. They've been working really hard for this. So the obvious question that many people would be asking: how will this affect the FSW draw? Guys, it's too early to predict about it. One thing to note, that these streams that have been announced today are different from Express Entry. The eligibility criteria are very easy. Even Express Entry's eligibility criteria are difficult when compared to that. So guys, it would be too early to predict or comment on its impact on the future FSW draws, when the next FSW draws will be conducted, how Canada is going to take it further. But yes, as and when we get to know about it, we'll definitely try to create more videos. Guys, another great thing about this announcement is that you can not only apply the permanent residency for the principal applicant, but also for their family members as well. Even if they are in Canada or if they are in your home country, you might be away from your family members and you might have never thought about it, that they would be able to come to Canada as a permanent resident, but now this would become possible because you can now apply for their permanent residency as well. Okay, now let's quickly talk about the eligibility criteria. Guys, these details that I'm sharing here are not very detailed, so if you want to see a detailed video on this, you can subscribe the channel. I would be uploading the detailed video on the weekend. Do not forget to check that out. Now let's first discuss the eligibility criteria for the international students that have recently passed out. So the first eligibility criteria is that they must have graduated from a Canadian university or college within the 4 years prior to applying. So let's say you're applying in June of 2021. So if you have passed out before June of 2017, you cannot apply, you won't be eligible. You must be employed in Canada with a valid work permit. And here the good thing is that they have not mentioned any details about the occupations as such. So which might be a big relief for all those students who have passed out recently and maybe working for the survival jobs. This is a big news, guys. They must intend to reside in a province or territory other than Quebec. And apart from that, the eligibility criteria for IELTS is very low. It's only CLB 5. Guys, there's no point system here. So it's not like if you score CLB 5, you'll be given less priority. And if you get CLB 9, you'll get more priority. No, it's not like that. At least it does not seem like that right now. What is CLB 5? It simply means that you need to score 4 in reading and 5 in the 3 other modules, which is very easy to score, guys. This is very, very easy. So it is a golden opportunity for all those international students who have recently passed out from Canadian universities or colleges. I will provide a link in the description. If you want, you can check it out, but I'll also make a video this weekend. You can watch that to check out the details as well. Now, the eligibility criteria for all the essential workers and the healthcare workers, they have been fantabulous. They've been working throughout the pandemic to provide us deliveries. They're working as janitors. They're working as plumbers. You would see multiple occupations that are listed out there. So you must have at least 1 year of Canadian work experience in an eligible occupation. I'll provide a link in the description box below. Which are those occupations, we'll discuss in the next video, in the detailed video. But if you're interested, if you're too curious, you can check that out right now. You must be currently employed in Canada. There's no salary cap as such. So that's a good news. That's also a very big news. You must intend to reside outside the province of Quebec. And the IELTS criteria is CLB 4. Guys, CLB 4 is very, very easy. If you know English, you would be easily able to score CLB 4. People strive to get CLB 9. That is the golden target. So guys, this is the golden opportunity. Do wait for the next video for this weekend, where I'll discuss about the eligible occupations and about the eligibility criterias in detail. Talking about the process, it hasn't been defined yet. It's not known. As and when we get to know about it, I'll make separate videos on that. But for now, for this video, that's it, guys. Thanks a lot for watching this video. Congratulations to all of those people who would be eligible and who would be getting the permanent residency very soon through these programs that have been announced yesterday.